I'm Pat Gunn, and this is part of my Let's Play series for Fallout 4.
Hey.
Go on.
Hey, Valentine.
Any chance you've rethought helping me close out some Nick Valentine history?
Sure thing. What's the case?
Well, this one's straight out of the archives.
So this can't tell us what we're going to be doing.
Once upon a time, in the land of Boston, there lived a king of organized crime, Eddie Winter. Hurt a lot of innocent people. But he knew the end was coming. So he sealed himself inside a...
An evil king in a sub shop. Does a meatball monster show up at some point?
Yeah, from what I've heard, the pastrami golem is the one you really have to watch out for.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, if you're done being a wise ass...
Never.
The story gets even more twisted. So he can come out of that shelter someday and...
Sure.
Only Eddie didn't want to be a frozen banana. No cryo sleep for him.
Well, Nick, you can't be saying what I think you're saying.
Oh, I'm saying it all right. Eddie Winter went and turned himself into a ghoul. And I'm convinced that he's still locked inside that shelter. I'm gonna find him and kill him.
All right, Nick. Let's get the bad guy.
Good. Now, I know where Winter's vault is.
Mm-hmm.
Back in the day, he recorded 10 holotapes. We find all of those holotapes, we get all the numbers.
Sure.
I've been putting together a file on this one for a while now, including one of Winter's. I managed to snatch from the Cambridge police evidence lockup before getting swarmed by ferals. My gut tells me the Boston police... It's probably worth paying...
Okay. So we're on a scavenger hunt, and we are asked to go and visit a whole bunch of police stations to get some information that we need to go after Eddie Winter. So to do this, let's see, we have not yet been to the Quincy one, so let's head down there. It is a giant weapon. I guess it's good that it has a handle on the side. That thing would be a real pain in the butt to carry. Probably you would want to have a stand on it to hold the weapon up while firing it. Okay. So, is this where we're going? Yeah. This looks like the work of raiders, probably. Hanging one of these scouty outposty things top of a wall. I cannot get on top of this wall from this side. So it looks like they thought some of this stuff through. They're controlling the means of approach. At least they were. Come on, get up. Okay, maybe I can jump over the wall from here. Yep.
Huh?
Oop. So yeah, they have their stuff together. They know what... They have a sentry, and they control the means of approach. Okay, and this person has a plasma rifle. Good choice. Not quite good enough, but they're very poorly armored.
Somewhere. What's that?
Useless.
Couldn't stay away.
Not a good sign when they're coming at you with rockets. Whole lot of sturdy combat armor. That's some good
Look
stuff.
Look who's back.
Down and we have some crops. Yeah, so let's see.
Yeah!
Whoa. Yeah.
Damn.
Wow. This is all very well thought out. It's
coop.
Yeah, big. It's a pity that you can't take this as your own settlement, because it would be...
You're dead! Damn. You have nothing.
Look who it is. Batman and a missile launcher. Very nice.
That's how you imagine this.
I wonder if it was just killing the unique group. Might have been.
Snoop them out.
Yeah, these guys, they're definitely well armored, well equipped.
Building a collection or something?
Always. Forgotten that the scavenger hunt really takes you into some pretty dangerous areas.
Nice.
You don't have to do this.
Interesting. So yeah, they've set up a lot of wires to relay
power
up.
I'm on him.
Wires are doing a weird little jiggle.
You're in for it now.
Actually, okay. Somebody is.
Something
was a good shot. I looked out there.
Guess I should stop putting off that detection. I'm not exactly subtle, pal.
Out of sight, so they're not far enough out of sight. Okay, I doubt that they're going to follow me all the way over here. Still marked as danger, though, so if I pop my head up, they'll immediately... Okay, now we're down to caution. We might be able to slip into... Decide and get a shot.
God, I hope there's a bounty on you!
Okay, anybody else coming? I don't think so. Except I'm still in danger again, so I need to wait for that to calm down. Oh dear. Got my sniper rifle. Oh, perfect. Perfect shot.
You are really pissing me off!
And somebody's coming right at me. And that was very dumb of him. I guess he just didn't realize that I'm equipped for short range and long range combat. And actually, I'm probably a little bit more deadly at short range because that flaming weapon. Okay, I'm still in danger. Okay, now we're to caution. Shot in there. Yep. And apparently they have really good hearing. Actually, they probably just more or less knew where I was. Okay, somebody is coming, and they're coming from downstairs. Back to caution. So maybe I can get a shot in. Okay, there he is. Yeah, but this, it's not yet up into the always hits range, and that's where I kind of want it to be. Okay, that's not useful. Yeah, that guy has amazing targeting ability. So let's see if we can maybe pop out here and see... Was somebody trying to sneak up on me? I think so. Okay, this is how we're gonna do it. Roll back up our kit bar. Doing lots and lots of little tiny hits. That from?
Engaging hostile!
Oh, that's probably the guy that probably just got a little bit of an angle on us from the window and used it to go after us. Wonderful. Yeah. Whoa! Again. Oh, yeah. That's what's going on. He is amazingly resourceful with finding ways to hit us.
Get some!
Prepare ourselves for short-range combat, just because I have this suspicion that the game is probably gonna try and toss somebody at us again. Okay, somebody's walking over there. It's probably a Clint. Okay. You turn away. That's what we want. I'm not sure if that did enough damage to his fusion core to cause it. Oh, it did. He's gonna... Yeah, and then he's gonna be forced out of his suit and be a whole lot easier to kill now. Awesome. If we can get in. But again, if you have the super, super fast weapon, and this is a custom gun, you'll generally be okay. Alright, so now we can see if we can get maybe another headshot on this Mr. Clint. Yep, he's out. And we can go see if he had any interesting loot. Oh, Nick. Get up.
You're playing with the wrong synth.
Yeah, so they're strongly controlling means of access here. Although they might not have... It may not have been their intelligence leading to it, but just pure luck. In that, I imagine moving these cars post-apocalypse is either not likely or you only have limited leeway to do so. So there's armor. But it's unfortunately set to wound.
See him?
Excellent.
There you go. I'll be doing the world a service.
Yeah, so they're making... Oop, I'm over the weight limit. Just a little bit of a weight limit. It's nice how later in the game, Whip stomps being a tourniquet, it starts being a rubber band around your wrist. Oh, there is another dude. And the gift of a boy. Disencumbered this soon, though. It's a little bit inconvenient. And since it's pretty much a binary quality, I heard that is not good. The car is going to be exploded pretty soon. Let's get it over with. He's standing there, right? Okay. So I don't want to explode with the car.
You know the radio plays that I air sometimes? It's occasionally in the right order. You know,
yeah, so... Definitely a neat design. Decent place to set up shop. Well defended. And the location itself is pretty great. So yeah, I think the Raiders at least picked great design for all of this. I don't, again, I don't know if they built it or if they just found it, but either way, definitely a good choice or good. Or a good construction. And no point in holding back because we're past the point where.
You must want to protect something awful precious.
Where it matters, so we'll just pick up everything. Looks like some stuff is going on down there. I don't know what it is. That's super mutants. I would guess that they're fighting. If it's not one of my trade bots. Super mutants versus raiders, I would guess. Might actually be a three-way battle, though.
Anything I can lug for you?
Once you have this set of perks where you can fast travel, if you're overloaded, and you've kind of resigned yourself to being in that state, you just grab absolutely everything that you can get your hands on. Now, it doesn't mean that we're going to be super reluctant to track things down. And if this gets me back down under, that's wonderful, but I'm not going to count on it. Powerfists are kind of fun, and they're pretty rare. Super potions are useless. Plasma rifles are pretty great. Yeah, I doubt that got me under, but if it did, wonderful. I think I'd need probably a new weapon. I'm still over. But that's fine. Stealing your food. Yeah, so this is a mature raider settlement. If I remember the backstory correctly, this used to be an ordinary settlement, like, maintained by people just trying to survive. But it turned out to be too successful, and it got the attention of the raiders, and they decided to come after it, and they successfully took it over. Okay, nothing good there. And you get the impression that it must have been quite a large settlement back in the day, because you will find beds all over the place. All the more pity that you can't clear it out for settlers again. But it's in a kind of dangerous part of the Commonwealth. But then again, a lot of the settlements are. So maybe that shouldn't be an excuse. Okay, the door where we want to be is right nearby, but maybe not in this building. Let's see what's up here. Oh, hello. I spy with my little eye. A gunner. Just here.
Last mistake!
Yep, your last mistake.
Oh.
Interesting. Oh yeah, it's, so it gives unarmed skill. That's how that works. I always kind of wondered how they coded up the power fist in armor effect there. But I never really was observant enough to spot that it just gives unarmed... well, wait, unarmed is not a... Oh, well, whatever. It at least gives us a pretty strong hand. So down we go into the police station to get one of Nick's tapes. Yeah, Quincy was a lot more exciting than I thought it was going to be. I kind of get the feeling that maybe that robot is going to activate at some point. I think that's what we wanted. A hard lock.
That's it.
Oh, just skin packs. Well, not that interesting. Looks like, yeah, somebody was trying to dig their way out using that wooden spoon that I just grabbed. Impressive. I guess if you give people a lot of time and just a basic tool, they can go quite a long ways. XP.
You a Geiger counter doing cartwheels too?
Apparently. And it's interesting. Apparently, Nick must have a built-in Geiger counter. Okay, so that was one of them. Probably be a good idea to sell some of this stuff to get back under the weight limit. Sell or drop stuff off, or both. Wish that you could get more than one of these Tesla rifles. They're cool looking, and their attacks are quite powerful.
Somebody went to a lot of effort to get...
And they use a very common ammo type, which helps. Oh, it's Cricket. Hi, Cricket.
Make a move and I'll end you. Wastelander.
Cricket.
So many guns and so little time. You just gotta buy them.
Let's see what you have.
Oh, goody. Let's make mischief.
Okay, so... Good intentions is not really my thing. Don't need that. Really, really don't need that. Power fist might be... Oh, but it's not a particularly special power fist. Yeah, let's sell it. There will be more power fists. And how are we doing on the ammo front? Yeah, it's nice that she has... She typically has a whole lot of ammo that you can buy. Oh, why not? Ooh, cryo cells. Seems like a pretty good way to get your, to make sure that, the trade is equitable enough. How I ended up with one of those. Some of these are kind of tempting to scrap, but not quite tempting enough to do so. And I just flat out wouldn't use that, so. Wow. Yeah, that's probably why I so rapidly filled up on my weight limit. So much combat armor stuff. See, it's if you ever find yourself hurting for funds, it's a pretty great way to immediately fix that. Ooh, sell a sweet roll and some deviled eggs. There. I think we're probably under weight limit again now. Yep. We still are carrying a lot of junk, so we will
could really kick
pop over to Country Crossing to drop that stuff off. Such a cool design.
Identity confirmed.
Yeah, down to 184. It's not perfect. But it's certainly, I guess we just have some excess meat, probably. Sell those steaks. Okay, that's probably good enough.
This unit is...
You can see...
Huh?
Yeah, lots of trade bots running around. I might want to take a quick nap just to
heal. Yeah. Need to
get back to diamonds.
Alright. On to the next one. Where else can we go? Natick Banks sounds like a good idea. I don't think we've been in this part of the map for quite a long time. Who am I here?
At least the Meyer alerts won't be hurting for housing.
Interesting. I don't quite know what that sound was. Is what the sound was. Hey, Mr. Legendary Deathclaw, can I aim at your face? Yes, I can. Perfect. It didn't quite clear out all the super mutants, but it went reasonably well. Okay, so police department. Is that a okay? That's a snake. Good. We want to be upstairs from here. How do we get there? place has really suffered a lot. This is how we'll get upstairs. This is plausible.
There we go.
Into the air. Anyhow, next is... this is a dangerous place to fast travel to, but let's do here and hope that we don't get blown up super quick. Things are pretty all right. Telephones are always full of good components. Okay. Oop, there's another Eddie Winter tape. But in order to squelch the fast travel marker, we have to do it to the terminal too. The way they programmed all this stuff. Yeah, I think we're a little bit low on nuclear material, so we're going to keep an eye out for that stuff. Okay, next is the Haunt. That's near Crew Manor. What? Oh, am I too near some enemies to travel? Probably. Pop out of mine a bit.
Our way out. Is someone present.
Oh, my goodness. Away to head to our next destination. I think we're probably far enough away now. Off to Crew Manor. Or is it Croup? Who knows? It's one of the annoying things about English. Like, you can... People often grumble about French not being pronounced a whole lot, or being pronounced similar to the way that it's written. And that's true, but it's a simple mapping to figure out, like, how do I get from here to there? With English? Not so much.
Could give a mutant nightmares.
With English, you have to know the origin of the word to know how to pronounce it or how to spell it. And fortunately, there are some large habits. Wasn't quite good enough. A whole lot of people are going to be going after it, not realizing that it will fail, and then a ghoul will pick it up. Good weapon, and they're legendary, and once you take them to half health and they recover, they're doing double damage. So, where are you?
We're about to go fast!
They almost killed me there. Ooh. Better job at aiming this time. That'll help. That's not a bad weapon. I'll look at that later on.
Hey.
I'm listening.
never mind.
Accounting for taste.
Okay, so yeah, we have to pop upstairs to see. Okay, where is it now? It is over here somewhere. Ah, there it is. This, and now I got it. Okay. Next will be, incidentally, it is really, really funny when you already have all of the tapes when you first go and talk with Nick. Wait, what? Okay, it hadn't cleared yet. An interesting design, although it doesn't really have motors around the legs or anything like that, so this design wouldn't quite work. Either that or they're very small motors. Okay, so we're back here. What? I think we've been here several times before.
You're mine now, rookie!
Smoking. Okay, there we go. Oh, did we already get the tape from in here? We might have.
You see him?
Well, that's annoying. Yeah, that's why you, while you're doing this, you want to make sure that you get both the terminal and the tape, because otherwise you'll have to return to the area. Boston Police Station, which is near the Mechanist Slayer. That works. Another very cool looking weapon. You would probably want to have another grip near the front of this thing if you're going to fire it while standing up. Station has definitely seen better days. Okay. One to go. Where is the last hardtop? It is. Isn't that where we are? Are we in the South Boston? No, we're in the East Boston. Okay. We're heading to Sobo. Kind of wonder what that round panel thing is in the back. Might not serve a purpose. A lot of this just might be they're doing what they can with the metals that they have available to them. Okay, so what we want is a little bit northeast of where we are, but there's a little bit of ammo stash here that looks like the railroad left it and marked it. Okay. Brotherhood patrols are here. Looks like they're people have probably tried to build settlements in this area, and they put up some giant walls. Is anybody in here? My frame rate is a little bit lower than I would like it to be. So we have here winter holotape logs. Okay, they are upstairs.
Inside, you got just a bunch of junk in here.
To see if we can curry a little bit more favor with Nick. Cape. C-A-P-E. Rats is
possible. I'm in.
We don't actually want to activate.
You sure you're not part synth? Of course. I guess you wouldn't know, would you?
Hey.
What so? You got something for me?
Heads up.
Maybe a pocket full of tapes belonging to an old ghoul?
What was it we were looking for?
10 tapes recorded. When you find them all.
Finally got them.
No fool. Wow. They're older than... And they've still got the code. Got it. 1-9. Yep, that yep. Old thug's hold up.
All right. So that is what we need to do then. Go wrap up Nick's quest line. First, we're going to pop down to Jamaica Plain to, again, drop off stuff. Note that you can do a whole lot of this stuff probably a lot quicker by not looting and by not taking the time then to drop stuff off or sell it or stuff like that. But I'm trying to do this Let's Play in a way reasonably similar to the way that I ordinarily play the game. that both reduces the need for off-camera time. Still need to think about that one. Not so useful. I'll come back and sell that at some point. Okay. And off we go. I guess we will do that in this video. We're gonna. We are going to actually. Nick's hopes and go after Eddie Winter. Just being well-armed and well-armored means that you don't need to plan nearly as much. This time it's not working that well. They designed this
covering
place in
fire!
A way
oh, baby!
That you can't so simply do that kind of strategy. So kudos to them. It's kind of a live pen test, maybe, of the arrangements. I did knock out quite a few of them, but. Obviously didn't do a perfect job because I had to retreat and heal up. Where did that body go?
Getting tired yet? Not keep Eddie waiting.
What? First mistake, last. Go to Zion.
Oh, now this is an interesting to build a fort. Station. This is a good way to do it. Set up lots of barriers to make people to control people's approach. Good places to hide and take cover. Some traps. Again, bravo to them. Can we get this open?
Got it.
Light
some blows there, but...
Someone should make use of it.
Yep. Kudos to them. This place is to sleep. See a little bit further? Yeah.
Yes.
Pleasant of lives in some ways.
Someone's coming.
Okay. Somehow I hit something explosive.
Hey.
Disappearing at.
Hey, I thought I saw something.
You're flirting a little bit with the smoke. It's the most destructible. But for a certain class of ground through, but we're doing okay ammo-wise. I think luck perks would probably make sense. And initially we just need to get our luck level high enough to start taking more of them. And let's save, because it always sucks to get power and level up and then die. Just in case something goes very wrong. Explosive gases, wonderful. Okay. Anything special? Oh, a boxing ring. That's pretty cool. Looks like this is probably what people bet. The results of boxing.
One, 9, 5, 3, 7, 2, 8, 4, 0, 6.
Oh no, you ain't walking away from this.
Now you know, bro. Look who's here.
Not me good yet.
Huh. Interesting. somehow.
We're done here. There's one more thing I've got to do. I wouldn't mind the company if you wanted to tag along.
Loot the place real quick, and then we can go. Yeah, ordinarily there's a great bit of dialogue here. I don't know why it didn't trigger.
Sweet.
Durasteel is a word? Interesting. I'm just being lazy here. Dwindling. Something in.
Sweet.
Yeah, that was just to. Okay, Nick, let's go. What do you need?
Nick.
Institute treats synths like tools, tossed away without a thought.
Oh, yeah. So he has a pretty cute little setup here. I'm kind of surprised, actually. Light bulbs in the Fallout universe must be considerably. Nick, what you doing, dude? Come on. We're heading out, right? Maybe he'll follow if I go up. See if it teleports to our side. If not, I hope he's not stuck down there. That would be pretty annoying. I'm not feeling super confident given. Yeah, given that the event did not fire, I guess we'll have to. Oh, here he comes. Good. That's kind of interesting. If I've ever seen this before, but pretty sure. Now, when it comes to speakeasies, this is probably not the best of design because it would be a little bit hard for people to go into without everybody noticing.
This is it. In this spot 200 years ago, one of Eddie's boys gunned down Jenny Lanz, my fiance. Nick's fiance. Now Eddie's as dead as Jenny and Nick. I'm at a loss. I just need some time to process all this.
You mind if we get out of here?
Yeah, that is if you're still interested in traveling together. I wouldn't blame you if you wanted some time on your own after all this.
Of course. Let's do it.
I'm glad to hear it. Come on, let's get out of here. And hey, thanks.
Okay, so that is the end of his dirty baggage, or dirty laundry. Didn't quite push us up to max affinity. Not sure how far off we are, but at least we're a little bit closer. So, that was the story of Nick. I kind of abbreviated it, but what happened is that the initial human of the name Nick Valentine was a detective, and he was assigned to a case to go after a mobster. But they were but the police were trying to go after more than one mobster, and so they decided not to arrest him as quickly as they otherwise might have. And that left, I think, the people around Nick's personal life kind of vulnerable. And the mobster went after the original Nick Valentine's fiancée, killed her. And Nick wasn't allowed to retaliate because they were still trying to go after more mobsters. I think that's what happened. I might be a little fuzzy on some of these details. Yeah, scoop up some of this stuff to go sell it. And this gave Nick some... Wait.
There's still someone alive under all that...
Just apparel left. Wait, why am I picking up mods? And so that gave Nick some mental issues. He went to get it, and the scientists scanned his brain while they were trying to figure out how to help him. So yeah, not a particularly pretty story. But sometimes in the real world, that kind of thing actually has to happen. You end up taking risks, and you have to deal with them, and sometimes people don't win out. And sometimes you don't have a happy ending.
Here.
And then, yeah, the monster disappeared. And the original Nick died somehow. And then the scanned brain image was turned back into, was loaded into the synth by the Institute many, many years later as part of their initial experimentations with human-like intelligence. End of story. And he just kind of dug through some of this on Nick's final companion quest. We will be traveling a little bit more with Nick while we get his affinity up to Max, and also out to Far Harbor. But for now, we're done. That'll be for a future video, or future set of videos. Bye-bye.